Hi, I'm Natalia Damini, and you're watching my most requested live Ask Anything Chat. Thank you so much, Romeo and iHeartRadio, for having me on the show tonight. My new single is called Pacemaker, and it features Petey Pablo. Now let's get to the questions. This is from Marcos from Chicago, Illinois. He says, hi Natalia, I love you as an artist and your music. I know you had your tour scheduled in April, but it was canceled due to the pandemic. Do you know when you'll be rescheduling the tour? Well, Marcos, as soon as it's safe, I can't wait to be back on tour and performing for you all. Next question is from Sarah from Los Angeles, California. Hi Natalia, how did the collaboration with you and Petey Pablo happen? It happened through my manager and Xavier Dedon, Concord Entertainment. He also works with Petey Pablo, so the song Pacemaker was already done, and he showed Petey Pablo, who immediately liked the song, and a few days later he jumped on the track, recorded, and that's how it happened. And in February this year, we recorded the music video, and by the way, it's out right now on my YouTube channel. Go check it out. It's pretty dope. Crystal from Manchester City, England. I recently found out that you wrote the World Cup song Vamos por la Estrella for Mexico for Patti Cantu and Sofia Reis. How was the experience for you? The experience was incredible because I love writing music. I write my songs. And not only I love writing my own music, but I also enjoy and I love writing for other artists too. So the experience was really good. Paula from Vancouver, Natalia, you are a really great dancer. Thank you. Who were some of the artists who inspired you as a dancer or performer? It's a long list, but my favorite artists, the main ones that really inspired me are Michael Jackson, Britney Spears, and Prince. They are the three main on my list, like top three. Next question, this is Ty from Brooklyn. And he says, would you and Petey ever tour together? Of course, we had something scheduled, by the way, but it had to be canceled due to the pandemic. But I can't wait to perform Pacemaker with Petey live. Okay, Carlos from Atlanta, Georgia. Have you participated in dance festivals? I did some festivals, but I haven't done EDM festivals yet, but I look forward to it. Logan from Los Angeles, California. How long have you been a singer? Hi Logan, I started out young, but it has been 10 years. Janelle from Las Vegas, how did you feel the first time you performed on stage? And do you get nervous before a show? The first time I performed on stage, it was very hard for me because I used to be on stage before, but dancing and not singing. So when I did that for the first time, I kind of choked up, I couldn't sing, I was too nervous. So I relied on my dancing, and in the end, everybody loved it. It worked out. Do you get nervous before a show? That's the next question. I still get nervous, but it's a good nervous now. I can focus more on being on stage and having fun. I think that's the best thing, to think when before you get to the stage. This is Luan from Washington, D.C., and he says, hi, Natalia Damini, would you also work as a model or actress if you had the opportunity? Love you. Luan, thank you. Modeling? Yes. Yes, I did some modeling before. And actress, acting? Yes, I definitely look forward to that. Okay, next, Lydia from Marietta, Georgia. What's your most favorite place you have performed? Also, love you, you're the best. Thank you, Lydia. The most favorite place I've performed, that's a very hard question because to me, it's not about the most favorite place. It's about the crowd, it's about the fans. It's how they interact with me when I'm on stage, when they're singing. No matter where I am, if I have this kind of interaction, this exchange of energy with the crowd, that place right there is gonna be my favorite place that I've performed ever in my life. So this is what I feel when I'm on stage, is that exchange with the people. It's more important to me. Mar from Spain, he asks, what are the worst and best aspects of being a solo artist? I think the worst is dealing with people, different opinions, egos, things like that, you know, and you gotta find some solution, an idea or something, and having to discuss that, and people having other opinions, and generating some unnecessary problems. And the best thing about being a solo artist is not dealing with that. Okay, next. Sarah from Parisburg, Pennsylvania. Where is your favorite place to travel to? I love traveling, but one of my favorite places is Miami, Florida, because I love tropical places and beach, so that's the place to go. Marlena from Columbus, Ohio. What's the first thing musically that you want to do after the quarantine? It's definitely perform. Definitely. I really look forward to that. Kaylee from Flushing, Michigan. What is the strangest thing you've bought during quarantine? I don't know if it's the strangest thing, but I bought a whole music studio setup so I could record my songs at home. And that's been pretty fun. I've been doing a lot of work so far. Emily from Swartz Creek, Michigan. I hope I'm saying it right. When was the first time you got recognized in public by a fan? It was in New York, New York Times Square. It was amazing having all the people come to me and take pictures, ask for autographs. That was pretty fun. Laura from Phoenix, Arizona. How does it feel hearing your song on the radio? It feels amazing. It feels very emotional because the creation of a song, when you work on that song from the scratch until it is done, is a whole process. And listening to it on the radio, I would say it's very rewarding. Lily from Beverly Hills, California. If you had the opportunity to ask one question to Michael Jackson, what would you ask? Wow, I definitely would ask if you want to work with me on a song together. Because that's my dream. And I am working with his brother right now, Tito Jackson. We're gonna have a song on my upcoming album, so look out for that. Gomes from Brazil. Hello, Natalia. What do you think is most important in music? Gomes, music industry, or music itself? If it's music industry, I would say the relationships. And music itself, it's the message that you give out to people. Jennifer from Pittsburgh. Coolest pair of shoes you own? My coolest pair of shoes are my boots that I perform. they're pretty comfortable. I can dance in them, so I think they're pretty cool. Thanks again for watching my most requested live AskAnythingChat. Thanks to Romeo for his support. I am Natalia Damini, and my new song is called Pacemaker, and it features Petey Pablo. Stay healthy and stay safe.